I'm going to teach you what you can do today to bring your blood sugar down naturally. And here's the truth. Most people think the only solution is medication or eating low carb or cutting out your favorite foods. But today, I'm going to show you 9 simple evidence-based steps that lower your blood sugar quickly and naturally using the Mastering Diabetes method. These steps are easy, they're safe, they're proven in peer-reviewed research, and when you do them consistently, your fasting blood sugar, your post-meal spikes, and even your A1C will start moving in the right direction fast. And then at the end, I'll walk you through 3 of the most dangerous myths that keep people stuck in insulin resistance. Seriously, if you keep believing these myths, you'll continue to struggle with management of the disease instead of reversing the root cause. So let's jump in. Tip number 1, start your morning with fiber, not fat. How you start the morning can shape your blood sugar for the entire day. Most people start their day with eggs, butter, bacon, or coffee with cream, and then wonder why their blood sugar spikes later. Here's why. Fat, especially saturated fat, reduces insulin sensitivity for hours. Think of insulin like a key and your cells like locks. When there's too much fat inside your muscle and liver cells, that lock gets jammed. So when you eat a high-fat breakfast, insulin can't work well, and glucose stays trapped in your bloodstream. The fix? Start your morning with fiber-rich foods that clean out the locks, not foods that clog them. Think foods like oatmeal, fruit, smoothies, leafy greens, high-fiber bowls. Fiber slows glucose absorption, improves insulin action, and sets you up for stable numbers all day long. And here's something important to understand. If oatmeal or fruit currently spike your blood sugar, it doesn't mean those foods are causing insulin resistance. It simply means your cells are already insulin resistant, and these healthy carbs are bringing the problem to the surface. Think of it like turning on a sink with a clogged drain. The water isn't the problem. The clogged drain is. When your muscle and liver cells are filled with excess fat, glucose can't enter easily. So even healthy foods look like they're spiking you. The solution is to remove the clog by lowering your dietary fat intake so your cells can clear out and then absorb glucose naturally again. So tomorrow morning, skip the greasy breakfast. Start with something that actually helps your cells unlock and function the way they're supposed to. And if you want our favorite low-fat breakfast recipes to help you do exactly that, comment guide below and we'll send them to you. Tip number 2, eat greens before carbs. This one is almost too simple, but the science behind it is shocking. A 2023 randomized controlled trial published in Nutrients found that when people with prediabetes ate non-starchy vegetables before their carbohydrates, their post-meal glucose dropped dramatically, in some cases by almost 40%, compared to eating carbs first. Why does this work? Because greens act like a buffer. When you eat leafy vegetables before high-carb foods, their fiber slows gastric emptying and reduces the rate at which glucose enters your bloodstream. So instead of a big spike, you get a slow, controlled rise, which gives insulin more time to work, even if you're currently insulin resistant. Think of greens as the glucose brakes on your meal. So anytime you eat potatoes, fruit, rice, beans, bread, pasta, eat a handful of greens first. Think spinach, kale, arugula, it doesn't matter. This 1-minute habit can flatten your entire glucose curve and make every meal more blood sugar friendly. Tip number 3, move for 10 minutes after meals. This is one of the fastest, most reliable ways to lower blood sugar in real time. You don't need the gym, you don't need weights, you don't even need to sweat. Just 10 to 15 minutes of light walking. It's that simple. A 2023 sports medicine systematic review and meta-analysis found that walking immediately after a meal significantly reduced post-meal glucose levels more effectively than walking later or exercising at another time of day. Why does this work? Because when you move right after eating, your muscles begin pulling glucose out of your bloodstream without needing extra insulin. It's like opening a second drain in a clogged sink. Glucose finally has somewhere to go. So after every meal, especially dinner, just move. Walk, clean the kitchen, climb stairs, put on music and dance for a few minutes. Movement is medicine, especially right after eating. Tip number four, hydrate to regulate. Most people don't realize this, but even mild dehydration can raise your blood sugar. When your body is low on water, the glucose already circulating in your bloodstream becomes more concentrated, which means your readings go up even if you didn't eat anything. Your kidneys also have a harder time clearing excess glucose when you're dehydrated, so sugar stays in your bloodstream longer. And here's the sneaky part. Most people think they're hungry or craving carbs, but they're actually just thirsty. Hydration is one of the simplest levers you can pull to stabilize glucose immediately. Here's how to use it. Start your morning with a big glass of water to rehydrate after 6 to 8 hours without fluids. Drink another glass before each meal. This improves digestion, slows gastric emptying, and can blunt glucose spikes. Sip consistently throughout the day instead of chugging large amounts at once. Want to level it up? Add fresh lemon to your water. The citric acid and vitamin C can modestly support insulin sensitivity and improve digestive enzyme activity. It's not a magic bullet, but it's a helpful, natural boost. This tip is simple, it's free, and it can make a meaningful difference in your daily blood sugar patterns, especially when combined with the other steps in this video. Tip number five, and this might surprise you, choose whole carbs, not low carb. Most people are told that carbs raise blood sugar, but that's only half the story. Carbs aren't the problem. Fat inside your cells is the problem. When your diet is high in fat, especially saturated fat, that fat gets stored inside your muscle and liver cells, and it jams up your insulin receptors. It's like pouring grease into a keyhole. The key still exists, but the lock won't turn. So when you eat carbs, they can't get where they're supposed to go. They stay stuck in your bloodstream. Carbs don't cause insulin resistance. They reveal it. But here's the good news. When you lower the fat and raise the fiber, whole food carbs become one of the most powerful tools you have to actually reverse insulin resistance. I'm talking about foods like fruit, oats, potatoes, beans, lentils, quinoa, brown rice, whole grain pasta. These foods don't create blood sugar issues. They fix them when you keep your diet low in added fat. And we have solid science showing exactly that. A randomized controlled trial published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition found that increasing whole grain intake reduced liver fat and improved insulin sensitivity even when people didn't lose weight. Another clinical trial, also in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition, showed that a low-fat, plant-based, high-carb diet dramatically improved insulin sensitivity and lowered A1C more effectively than the ADA diet, and there was no calorie counting required. So next time someone tells you carbs spike blood sugar, remember this. Carbs aren't the clog. Fat is the clog. Whole food carbs are the solution. And if you want our favorite low-fat, whole carb recipes that improve insulin sensitivity, just comment guide below and we'll send them to you. Tip number six, get enough magnesium. Magnesium deficiency is extremely common in people with diabetes, and it directly interferes with how well your insulin receptors work. And here's the part most people never hear. One of the strongest randomized controlled trials we have, published in Diabetes Care showed that magnesium supplementation significantly improved fasting glucose, insulin sensitivity, and A1C in people with type 2 diabetes who were magnesium deficient. No fad diet, no supplements promising miracles, just restoring a missing mineral, and their insulin sensitivity improved. Here's why. Magnesium is required for insulin signaling. When you don't have enough, your cells become sluggish and stop responding properly, which means higher glucose, higher insulin, and more insulin resistance. So make magnesium a daily habit. These foods are naturally rich in magnesium and fit perfectly into the Mastering Diabetes low-fat plant-based method. Spinach, pumpkin seeds, black beans, Swiss chard, oats, bananas. Add these foods to your meals every single day and your insulin receptors will respond better. Tip number 7, use vinegar-based dressings with your meals. You don't need to drink apple cider vinegar. Just use it in your meals. Real research backs this up. A study in Diabetes Care found that adding vinegar with a high-carb meal significantly reduced post-meal glucose and insulin levels. Another randomized trial in clinical nutrition showed improvements in fasting glucose and insulin resistance in people with type 2 diabetes. Why? The acetic acid in vinegar slows digestion and helps your muscles take up glucose more efficiently. So instead of drinking apple cider vinegar, use it like this. Make a simple dressing with apple cider vinegar, lemon, mustard, garlic, and a little hummus. Drizzle it on salads, potatoes, beans, or bowls. Use it regularly with meals. It's an easy, tasty way to flatten your glucose curve. Tip number 8, sleep more, stress less. One night of poor sleep can make you 25% more insulin resistant the next day. That's how powerful sleep is. And chronic stress, the kind you carry quietly throughout the day, increases cortisol, which raises glucose whether you eat perfectly or not. Improve sleep by dimming lights at night, avoiding screens for 30 minutes before bed, cooling the room, reading or stretching. Your pancreas will thank you in the morning. Tip number 9, ditch the oils. This is the most underrated tip on the planet. Even small amounts of oil, olive, avocado, coconut, can block insulin sensitivity for hours. Why? Because oils are 100% fat, 0% fiber, extremely calorie dense, and they're rapidly absorbed into your bloodstream. A 2017 clinical trial published in Nutrients found that just one day of high fat eating reduced whole body insulin sensitivity by about 28%, showing how quickly dietary fat can interfere with glucose uptake. That means your carb spike wasn't from carbs. It was from the fat you ate before them. Remove the oil and numbers start improving fast. And if you want delicious, oil-free, blood sugar-friendly recipes, just comment guide below and we'll send them to you. Now let's talk about 3 dangerous myths that keep blood sugar high. Myth number 1, fruit spikes blood sugar. Fruit does not cause insulin resistance. Fat inside your cells does. Fruit only spikes if your cells are clogged. Fix the clog, fix the spike. Myth number 2, you need high protein foods to manage diabetes. Protein isn't bad, but the source matters. Research by Dr. Walter Longo showed that high animal protein intake increased diabetes mortality 5-fold, while plant protein showed no such risk. Beans, lentils, edamame equal good. Meat, eggs, cheese, not ideal for insulin resistance. Myth number 3, carbs cause diabetes. The biggest myth of them all. Metabolic ward research, which are controlled human studies, have shown for decades that high-fat diets cause insulin resistance, not carbs. Carbs simply reveal the problem. Reduce dietary fat, increase healthy carbs, and insulin sensitivity skyrockets. So let's recap. Start your morning with fiber. Eat greens before carbs. Move after meals. Stay hydrated. Choose whole carbs. Get magnesium. Use vinegar. Sleep well. Drop the oils. And ignore the myths. Every one of these help you remove the fat clogging your cells so glucose can finally flow where it belongs, into your muscles, not your bloodstream. If you want our free recipe guide that makes all of this easy, comment guide below and we'll send it to you. If this video helped you, hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and share it with someone ready to improve their blood sugar. Until next time, keep those carbs high and that A1C low.